So the Earth provides lots of choices for clean, low-carbon energy. And Brazil, China, and Texas show there are ways forward. But can we afford it? Can society make the kinds of changes needed? Well, we've done it before.
Let's take a walk through history in Edinburgh, Scotland. But it could be many other big cities a couple of centuries ago. Here's what a visitor from London wrote in 1754.
When I first came into the high street of that city, I thought I had not seen anything of the kind more magnificent. The extreme height of the houses, which are, for the most part, built with stone and well sashed.
It's evening. Time for a wee bite.
Scottish taverns, then as now, were noisy places, buzzing with good conversation and high spirits.
The visitor from London dined well and drank a few glasses of fine French claret. But then his new friends did something that was second nature to them in the 18th century, but seems very strange to us today.
The clock struck 10. Then the company began to light pieces of paper and throw them upon the table to smoke the room.
Lighting those pieces of paper was meant to mix one bad smell with another.
You see, 10 o'clock was when you could empty brimming chamber pots down into the streets.
The London visitor safely dodged the terrible shower, but then he was forced to hide between his bed sheets to avoid the smell pouring into his room from the filth. And yet the people had gotten used to this, to the inconvenience and disease, and some people made a living hauling away the human waste.
The English visitor thought all this simply had no remedy.
Anything so expensive as a conveyance for the waste down from the uppermost floor could never be agreed on, nor could there be made, within the building, any receiver suitable to such numbers of people.
So what do chamber pots have to do with carbon dioxide and sustainable energy? Not to mince words, we're pouring CO2, another form of human waste, into the public space. And we'll have to deal with the consequences if we don't clean it up.
Today, of course, most of us have conveyances down from bathrooms and sinks to wash in and receivers for our waste.
What happened? Look around your house. How much did the porcelain thrown in your bathroom really cost?
It took a considerable investment for all those pipes bringing water to wash with and to take the waste away. The revolution in hygiene involved an extensive infrastructure of toilets and homes, sewers underneath our cities, water treatment plants. Today we might call it the sanitation smart grid.
So how much did all this cost? Not that much if you consider the millions of lives saved with clean water, prevention of diseases like cholera and typhoid. Something like 1% of the economy in very round numbers. And that's more or less the estimated cost of switching the world to a sustainable energy system that doesn't dump fossil fuel CO2 into the public space. Cleaning up the cities took decades and even centuries, and we're trying to do things a little faster. But the revolution in waste management shows that we can do big things to get benefits that none of us would ever walk away from.